coming at you, showing you how to make an awesome shield.
All right, so this is what I used for the project. All right, so this wood is like 3/4 inch, I believe, plywood. So yeah, and then there's like a handle thing. All right, so plywood cost me about $8. Handle about $3. Rivets I might need or I might not. So I don't know. They cost me $5 though. And I had scrap metal. So yeah, I'm gonna show you how to build something cool. All right, so the first step that I'm gonna do is draw the design out. So it's not gonna be like a round shield, cause I mean most of them are, but I'm gonna be adding something really cool to it. So yeah, once I get the design out,
I'm gonna show you. So this is what I came up with. All right, I'll show you it real quick.
Yep. All right, so that right there is my arm. This is the strap that's gonna hold my arm down. This is the handle. Yeah, from the middle right there, I don't know if you can see this, a barely pencil drawing, but I did the cross, and that's a really good way to find the center. But I drew from here all the way to the top of here, and I'll tell you what this is in a second. And that is 15 and half. Yeah. And on the other side too. So on this is this metal part. So I'm gonna make like spikes and stuff. So if you ever, it's gonna be on your left arm too. But if you ever like, I don't know, your weapon falls or something, you can use this as a weapon too. So yeah, this is the measurement of 3 of those pieces right there. So yeah, now I'm gonna cut these 2 lines out. And I might cut out some more right here, like that, just to like reduce the weight, because this is kind of heavy. But I don't know, I'll see how much it weighs with that cut off. So yeah, I'll get back to you going. I like how it turned out. Yeah. I mean, it's not that heavy, kind of is, but it's all right. If it gets too heavy once I put the handle and the strap on, then I'll probably just cut off. It doesn't really matter. But right now, I'm gonna drill the holes for the handle. And then I'll get back. So now I'm gonna wrap this handle so it won't just be metal and it won't be uncomfortable. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna wrap it first all in duct tape, then I'm gonna wrap it with paracord. Alright, so I'll show you how that turns out. So I finished giving it a paracord wrap. I think it looks pretty cool and it feels pretty comfortable. So yeah, now the next step is, so this is the thing that's gonna keep my arm in place so I just don't have to grab the handle. And it'll give me more support and stuff. So what I've done is I made some creases on a 2 inches mark. This is about 14 inches long. So yeah, 2 inches. And then what I'm gonna do is drill some holes in the wood, and I'm gonna like heat up a nail and stick it through it, because it's the best way to get a good hole in this material. And then I'm gonna get this washer and this rivet, put it in, pop it, and hopefully it keeps my arm in place. Yeah. Alright, now that I got that done, I'm gonna stick my arm through and kill right here, and then I'm just gonna like slowly bring it out so it leaves the form of my arm, and I got it somewhat. So yeah, then I marked some places, I mean some dots, and then I drill it out and pop the rivets, and we're all good. So we got that riveted and fits my arm quite nice. So yeah, now I'm gonna screw this in place. Turned out awesome. It fits my arm really good.
and it feels really cool. But there is another way you can make it more comfortable, but I don't have the way. But you get like a piece of foam, like a foam block, and you put it right here, and then yeah, your arm fits on that. But it's okay, my arm is comfortable on here. So yeah, it turned out pretty cool. We're gonna start on the blade next, but I'm gonna show you something. So that right there is because I didn't put a piece of block on the like on the back of it. So yeah, it blew out a hole and stuff. So yeah, it doesn't look that bad, but it still looks kind of bad. But I can fix that with spray paint because I'm gonna spray paint it. But another way, like to prevent it from happening at all, is to just put another piece of scrap wood like this, wood cut off, and then that'll prevent any of this. So yeah, just a tip. Yeah, now we're gonna start with this point. Your shield can be done if you want, but I'm gonna add some blades to it to make it like a weapon. So yeah, I'm gonna draw the design out for the blade. So I got it cut out, and yeah, it's just basically 2.5 inches on each one. Yeah, I'm gonna cut out 3. Yeah, get to cutting. I got it cut out roughly. Yeah, I know it looks really bad. But yeah, I'm gonna fix it up, make it look pretty good. Yeah, give it a nice bevel, and then sharpen it. I got all this ground down shape. Yeah, I think it looks pretty nice. Yeah, I've got a question. If you'd hear me out, in your defense, you never had a chance. And so tell me straight, I won't go. This is our time now, I'm sure. Make no mistake that we are. Closer than we're far. And while that's drying, listen to some jams. Turned out, I think looks pretty cool. Show you real quick. Yep. So yeah, now we're gonna drill holes right here, 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 and yeah, pop some rivets.
I've got a question. If you'd hear me out, out. In your defense, you never had a chance. And so tell me straight, I won't go.
There it is. How this turned out. Turned out amazing. Yeah, I'll show you real quick. Went on, of course. And there's the blades. Turned out pretty cool. So, please check out the rest of my channel. There's pretty cool stuff like this. Yeah, thank you for watching. Yeah, I guess that's all I have to say. So, see you next time on Crunch 101.